We are just days away from a historic solar eclipse. Next Monday, April 8th, millions of Americans will be able to see the moon pass right in front of the sun. And here to tell us more about this exciting experience is NASA expert Dr. Kelly Korreck, who is joining us live right now. Good morning, Dr. Korreck. Nice to have you on.
Good morning, Elizabeth. Thank you so much for having me.
Yeah, this eclipse is one major viewing event, let me tell you. So we understand that California is not in the path of totality, but we are going to be able to get to see part of this solar eclipse. Isn't that right?
Definitely. The entire United States, contiguous United States, will get at least a partial eclipse. And there in San Diego, you'll get about a 53% eclipse. So there will still be something to see.
Okay, that's going to be awesome and exciting. And now that we're building up and leading up to Monday, we've been told never to look directly at the sun. So how can we view it safely?
Yes, we do want to make sure that we're definitely viewing this event safely so everyone can enjoy it. So we're going to use something like these solar eclipse glasses that are much darker than sunglasses. These are not sunglasses. They're much darker. They're eclipse glasses. And you're going to use these anytime you're looking at a non-fully eclipsed sun. So you would put them on, then look up, and then take them and then look down to take them off in order to enjoy this safely. And if you don't happen to have a pair of these, you can also have an indirect viewing method. So indirect just means that your back is to the sun, and you can use things like a kitchen strainer and hold it out to the side, and it'll project that eclipsed sun onto the ground. Or you could even use your fingers and cause little pinholes where the sun can get through and project onto the ground.
Yeah, many of the, I can imagine on Monday, a lot of the schools might be helping kiddos make those types of, you know, devices or paper items to help watch the eclipse safely. Now, the last time we saw a solar eclipse was back in 2017. Is that right? What makes this year's different?
Correct. So last time we saw in the U.S. a solar eclipse was 2017, but somewhere on Earth, about every 18 months, we get a total solar eclipse. What makes it so unique is any location on Earth is about 400 to 1,000 years before they get that chance to see the total in their place. The other is that this is much wider and it's much longer than the other one. So it's a little bit different and well worth the trip to see.
Now, where are you at right now? Are you in Maryland right now?
I am currently in Maryland, but I'll be traveling to Cleveland, Ohio in order to view the eclipse.
Okay, because that obviously Cleveland, Ohio is in the path of totality, right?
Yes, it is.
All right. And lastly, before we let you go, Dr. Korreck, can you tell us where we can get more information and how to prepare for this upcoming eclipse?
Definitely. You can go to gonasa.gov/eclipse2024 to get more information.
All right. Definitely going to be a sight to see safely, of course. Thank you, Dr. Korreck, for your time.
Thank you.